go to Jesus, shall we?
Yes.
In Battle Creek, Michigan, listening online. Jesus, bienvenido.
Gracias. Hi, Patrick. Hi, hey, Tim. Can you guys hear me?
Okay. Yeah, clear as a bell.
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Okay, Tim, so my question is, what is the difference between sanctifying grace and agape? And I'm asking this question because I want some clarification.
Right.
I understand that we're justified by the infusion of grace and the transformation of our soul.
Yes.
But I have seen written at Call to Communion, the website, that Dr. Brian Cross has written that when God justifies us, he infuses sanctifying grace and agape. And so I just need some clarification. Are they the same? Are they distinct? What is the difference?
And what is agape?
It's a great, great question, Jesus. And for the folks who may not know, agape is the Greek word for love. It's one of four Greek words for love, and it's a very special word in that. In fact, in Pope Benedict's encyclical letter, was that Spes Salvi? It might have been the one on love.
Yes. I want to say Ubi Caritas, but that's the Latin
here. Or Caritas
Est? We'll get it.
Yeah, anyway. we'll get it, yes. I believe it was his encyclical letter on love. He points out, Jesus, that agape is a word that really wasn't used for what Christians used it for in sacred scripture, because we had a new thing happen in salvation history when Jesus Christ, and that is the second person of the Blessed Trinity, the eternal Word, became incarnate. The love of God walked among us. And so love was manifest in a way that we had never known it before. And the reality of the infinite love of God that subsists within the inner life of God in the very core of the Trinity, right? The Father's love for the Son, Son for the Father, Father and Son for the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit for the Father and Son, that infinite and perfect circle of love was revealed to us in and through Jesus Christ. And so agape is a term that had a different meaning, even in the Old Testament Septuagint, but it became the word used in the New Testament for the love of God, this love that we're talking about that was revealed in Jesus Christ. Now, that is very important, Jesus, because what we're talking about when we talk about agape from a Catholic Christian perspective, we're talking about the love of God that is manifest, revealed in Jesus Christ. Now, the difference between sanctifying grace and this love is ultimately love, agape, is God, or we could say God is love. Agape is God in its essence. God is love. Sanctifying grace is not love. Sanctifying grace is a created grace, that is, God gives us sanctifying grace to be the instrument whereby we can participate in that love. So through that sanctifying grace, the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts. That, as Romans 5:5 says, the love of God, the agape of God, is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit. Sanctifying grace would be that instrument. So we really do experience the agape, the love of God, in our souls, and we participate in that very love and life of God through that sanctifying grace. So that, Jesus, when we're baptized, we are incorporated into Jesus Christ, and we experience, in accordance with the gift of grace that God has given us and our cooperation, we participate in that infinite love of God. Now, we can never participate in it infinitely, of course. Only the persons of the Blessed Trinity do. But we participate in that love, and that is through the instrument of sanctifying grace.
I thought he was asking a yes or no question.
That's right. Yeah. Yes.
By the way, let me lay some Latin on you. This will sound really familiar. Deus caritas est.
How could we forget that? Both of us.
Yeah. Caritas in Veritate was his third encyclical, so you can understand why
gotcha.
We conflated them. Yeah, that was his. He did sort of a trinity of them, didn't he?
Yes.
On God is love, of course, Spes Salvi, saved by hope, and Caritas in Veritate, love in truth.
Yes.
Jesus, how's that for a light-shedding answer?
Yes, it definitely was, because I was just a little confused about the quality and the end, because I do have the understanding that they are distinct.
Yes.
It's just that when it comes to the increase of justification, I was just a little confused as to, you know, how that plays out in the overall
sure
topic of justification.
Well, Jesus, when we talk about increasing in justice, that is basically our going deeper into participation in the life and love of God. And so we really do become, where is it, 1 John chapter 3, right around verse 9, as I recall, verse 7, actually. The one who does justice, it's hopaion tein dikaiosune dikaios esten in Greek, which means the one doing justice is just. So the church has used that text to show how that we can increase in our justice or righteousness by cooperating with grace. And so there we go deeper into the love of God and participate in that love of God in a deeper way.
What was that? Hope kanatai kanene?
Hopoyon tein dikaiosune dikaios estin.
Oh, okay. Yeah, just to clarify.
I know you didn't catch that last estin, I think.